Hello, ma'am. I'm audible.
Yes, you are.
Okay. So I'll be beginning with unidentified human remains to unknown medical history can always possess biological hazards to forensic personnel, including hepatitis C, HIV infection, MERS, and now SARS-CoV-2. By taking all the precautions and recommendations, the highlighted risk can be minimized. So hello, friends. A very good afternoon to all of you. Myself, Dr. Harithma Nigam, would like to present a questionnaire-based study, the title for which is Awareness of Biosafety and Infection Control Measures During Dental Autopsy in Pandemic COVID-19. Next slide, ma'am. The seventh strain of coronavirus, it came into limelight in Wuhan city of China on December 31st, 2019, and WHO declared it as a pandemic. Its major pathway is through aerosols, which enter to the host cell either through oral cavity or nasal cavity or both. It is seen that the spike proteins of coronavirus has a strong affinity for ACE receptor protein, which is available, which is located in various parts of oral cavity. And SARS-CoV-2, it persists on the surfaces for days and in nasal cavity for about 3 days after death. Therefore, cadavers possess biological hazards. Next slide, ma'am. Henceforth, it must be handled very safely. Its transportation, storage, autopsy, and cremation should be done under precaution. Henceforth, autopsy of unidentified person whose death is due to COVID-19 should be performed only for identification purposes or forensic reasons. There are various dental autopsy measures like dental odontograph, social profiling, dental cast, denture marking system, and dental radiograph. Therefore, the aim of my study is the awareness of biosafety and infection control practices among forensic odontologists during dental autopsy in the current era of COVID-19. It is a questionnaire-based study consisting of 120 forensic odontologists based on 5-point Likert scale. This questionnaire is categorized into two. Category 1, consisting of 6 questions based on general information, and Category 2, consisting of 9 questions regarding the role of forensic odontologists. Its inclusion criteria was those forensic odontologists who were willing to participate in the current study, and those who were not willing or they were absent, they were just excluded from the current study. This next slide, ma'am. The aim of my current study was the awareness of biosafety and infection control practices among forensic odontologists during dental autopsy in the current era of COVID-19. It is a questionnaire-based study consisting of 120 forensic odontologists based on 5-point Likert scale. It is broadly categorized into category 1, in which 6 questions were based on general information, and category 2, 9 questions based on role of forensic odontologists. Its inclusion criteria was those forensic odontologists who were willing to participate in the study, and exclusion criteria was those who were absent or those who were not willing during the data collection. Next slide, ma'am. So on one side, it consists of those questionnaires, which was category 1, consisting of your general information. And on the other side, the results were the questions with strongly agreed were, is forensic odontologist an effective manpower? Coronavirus have strongly affinity for ACE2 receptors found in oral cavity. Or it is declared as a modified disaster in many countries, including India, and all suspected and victims should be screened for symptoms of COVID-19 before entering healthcare facilities. And the question for agree were, if crime rate and violence has increased due to strict nationwide lockdown, and it persists on surfaces for days in nasal cavity and for 3 days after death. Next slide, ma'am. Next slide. This is another questionnaire that is category 2, consisting of role of forensic odontologist. The questions for strongly agreed were electronic records availability of anti-mortem records and promotion of forensic odontology, the 3D scanning of dentition, maintenance of dental cast, intraoral photography, saliva or spray samples are really very helpful in maintaining anti-mortem records. 3D scanning, it minimizes contact with saliva and surfaces. Forensic odontologists should consider every case as a potential positive case of COVID-19. Protocol for DNA sample and collection and transport should be done for RT-PCR test. Autopsy plays a significant role in autopsy of infectious diseases, and correct training of PPE usage should be given, and dental autopsy should be postponed if it is unavailable. The question for agree was, Electronic dental health records minimizes cross-infection. And the question for in a neutral zone was dental autopsy and DNA both are primary identifiers of death or no. Next slide. These were the two graphs which were plotted against my study. An ANOVA test was performed and the result came out to be statistically significant. Next slide. Coming to the discussion, COVID-19 pandemic is considered to be an emergency condition nowadays and it has a lot of risk of serious infection. All the professionals, including pathologists and forensic odontologists, they play a significant role in diagnosis and treatment of patients. There are chances of possible contact with infected material from corpuses, splashes, and aerosol diffusion. And it is considered to be as under third of all the four hazardous group of infectious biological agents. The infection can be caused due to dermal inoculation, inhalation, ingestion, contamination of intact skin or oral, nasal, and eye mucous membrane. Next slide. Therefore, there are certain protocols which should be followed by all the forensic personnel. Firstly, forensic personnel must be previously educated about the risk and the prevention. A number of forensic personnel should be limited in the autopsy room and video registration should be preferred. Antiseptic hand hygiene procedures should be followed and special attention should be given while touching the face. Proper usage of PP kit should be given to all. And for example, disposable headgear should be used, disposable gloves, which must be extended to cover wrist, disposable or double mask and face protection gears, fluid resistant gown, surgical cap, disposable rubber boots and waterproof shoe protectors should be used. Special attention must be paid to the correctness of donning and doffing of all the procedures. And necessary instruments must be available in the autopsy room. Virtual autopsy, that is your autopsy, is best. If it is not present, if it is not available, then OPG, CBCT, and MRI should be preferred. And all the surgical procedures should be postponed still for just because of your infected aerosol. Next slide. Now to conclude, the current spread of COVID-19 must assume human remains are potentially infected. To balance safety and respect of human rights of death, forensic odontologists involved in autopsy procedures must be well trained in infection prevention control practices. And lastly, I want to say, the dead cannot cry out for justice. It is a duty of the living to do so for them. These are my references. Thank you.